Hi, my name is Nithiik Khuranaa, an upcoming sophomore at Fairmont Preparatory Academy in Orange County, California. Today, I would like to talk to you about the future of learning with AI. Imagine this, a teacher who never sleeps, who knows your learning style, a teacher that never gets tired and doesn't judge you for asking the same question 10 times, a teacher that doesn't get frustrated when you fail and celebrates when you finally understand. Now imagine that same teacher is with you every step of the way. Not just in school, but throughout your entire life. Sounds like something out of a science fiction novel, right? But it's not. It's already here. It's called artificial intelligence, and it's changing the way that we learn forever. Today, I want to show you how AI is not a futuristic fantasy or a classroom distraction, but rather a revolution in learning. A revolution that is not about replacing humans, but about unlocking human potential. But before we talk about the opportunities, we need to address the fear. Because let's face it, there's a lot of it. In many schools and homes, AI is seen as a threat. It's viewed as a shortcut or worse, a way to cheat. Students are told not to use it, teachers are warned about it, and some schools go as far as banning it completely. And in all of that panic, we miss the bigger picture. This fear-based response creates a dangerous narrative that AI undermines learning, but the truth is far more hopeful. Because AI, when used ethically, creatively, and wisely, enhances learning. It nurtures curiosity, promotes self-reflection, and it makes knowledge more accessible. So let me say this as clearly as I can. AI is not the enemy of education. It is the opportunity of a lifetime for every learner everywhere. But let's start with the basics. AI in education isn't about replacing teachers and machines. It's about creating learning environments that are smarter, more personalized, and more human-centered. AI-powered learning platforms can assess where a student stands, adjust difficulty levels, suggest new material, and deliver content in the format the student prefers, whether that's videos, quizzes, summaries, or simulations, because some students learn by doing, some by watching, some by listening, and some by failing repeatedly until it clicks. And AI has the capacity to honor all of these signals simultaneously. It can give instant feedback, suggest improvements, and repeat concepts in different ways until true understanding is achieved. You see, traditional education often assumes we all learn the same way. Same chapters, same tests, same deadlines, but we are not all the same. And when we're given a tool that sees us as individuals, that's when the real learning begins. And this isn't just a philosophy, it's backed by research. In a 2020 study published in Nature Human Behavior, a group of students used an AI-based tutoring system developed by researchers at Carnegie Mellon University. And the result was truly shocking, because students using the AI system to learn algebra did much better than those who didn't. Why? Because the AI adapted. It saw mistakes not as failures, but as signals. It adjusted its teaching method, its language, and its pace. Now compare that to the traditional model. A student struggles in class, they fall behind, they lose confidence, and the system moves on without them. But with AI, that system stays. It slows down, it rewinds, and it reteaches. And it never says, you should have already known this. That's powerful. Currently, I'm building an educational AI platform, and when I started, I asked a simple question. What if every student had a personalized roadmap to success? Not a fixed syllabus, but a living, breathing guide that adjusted every single day. So I built it, a platform for test prep and subject mastery, one where the moment a student logs in, it tailors everything, from content to coaching, just for them. And over time, I've seen the same three benefits again and again. Number one, instant feedback. When students get immediate answers, they correct mistakes faster. No more waiting for the teacher to grade your paper next week. AI helps bridge the gap between confusion and clarity in the moment when it matters most. Number two, memory optimization. My platform uses smart algorithms based on spaced repetition, a technique where information is revisited just before it's forgotten. And this simple idea improves retention dramatically. No more cramming and forgetting, instead, learning that sticks. And number three, emotional relief. Let's not forget, school is stressful, deadlines, pressure, competition, but AI can organize study schedules, recommend breaks, offer bite-sized content, and encourage positive learning habits. And in doing so, it relieves the mental burden that too many students carry alone. And when we talk about AI in education, we often talk about grades, test prep, exams, but it goes so much deeper because we're preparing students for a world where AI will be present in every career, every decision, and every invention, from diagnosing diseases to writing music. The leaders of tomorrow will be the ones who know how to work with AI, not be afraid of it. But we can't wait till they graduate to teach them that. We need to start now, because right now we are standing at the edge of one of the biggest revolutions in the history of learning. Not because of a tool, but because of a choice. Do we choose fear, or do we choose transformation? Do we hold back the future, or do we guide students into it with courage and clarity? This moment reminds me of the printing press. At first, people resisted it. They feared that books in every home would ruin the minds of the young, but the printing press didn't destroy knowledge, it publicized it. And AI is our printing press moment, and we must treat it not as a threat, but as a teacher. Because at its best, AI doesn't replace what makes us human, it amplifies it. Curiosity, resilience, creativity, empathy. AI gives us space to grow, to learn from failure, to try again, to go deeper. And this isn't just about algorithms. It's about potential, and it's about every student who was told they weren't enough, finally realizing that they were more than enough. So let me end with this. The question isn't whether AI will change education, because it already is. The real question is, will we rise to meet that change with open mind and open hearts? Because if we do, we won't just build better students, we'll build a better world.